Why do we waste segregate? Did you know that about 35,580 tons of garbage is generated every day in the Philippines? On the average, each person in the country produces about 0.5 kilograms and 0.3 kilograms of garbage every day in the urban and rural areas. The household is a major source of waste in the Philippines at 74%. Moreover, of the total solid waste generated from households, 95% can still be reused or recycled or turned into compost. Only 5% is made up of residuals and special or hazardous waste that are no longer usable or biodegradable. Only 40 to 85% of the waste generated is collected nationwide, implying that 15 to 60% is improperly disposed of or littered. The uncollected garbage is unfortunately burned or dumped anywhere into open areas called open dumps, adding to the now polluted air, shed, and water body, and global warming in the country. So what is its implications in our environment? First, it could lead to soil contamination. Plastics, metals, papers, and certain types of glass can all be recycled at your local recycling center. If you take the time to send these items to recyclable locations, the items can be reused and returned to consumers. They won't end up as trash or hurting the environment. If recyclables are placed into the ground, they can potentially contaminate the surrounding soil. Second is air pollution. Paper, plastics, and other materials that are burned can contaminate the air when they are burned. Over time, the chemicals can build up in the ozone layer. Third, animals and marine life. Humans are not the only ones affected by improper garbage disposal. Animals are too. Garbage dumping and discharging raw or untreated sewage can threaten marine life and animals who come in contact with the water. So here are tips on how to segregate your waste. Tip number 1. For kitchen or wet waste, do not collect in plastic covers. Keep the waste in plastic packets with lid or can use the waste as fertilizers. Tip number 2. For biomedical waste, wrap in a newspaper and mark with a red cross. Keep outside the house or empty in a separate bin. Tip number 3, for hazard or wet waste, keep them in the house in a separate bin. Tip number 4, for dry waste, keep them in the house in a white gunny bag. Ensure all bottles or plastic covers are cleaned and dry. Proper waste disposal can help prevent pollution. Learn proper waste disposal to avoid damaging our environment. And always remember the 3 R's: reduce, reuse, recycle.